Good karma, my aesthetic. Keep my conscience clear, that's why I'm so magnetic. Manifested, I finesse it. Take my pen and write some love letters to heaven. Hi my loves, and welcome back to another video. So we're just gonna go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna be taking my Ruby Kisses cream foundation, and I'm going to be using the darkest shade to the right, and I am going to be putting that all over this bald cap. So originally I was not going to do a video of me doing my hair from start to finish. I was just gonna do a video of me crimping my hair, but after I did the bald cap method, I was just like, okay, why not? So if you guys are subscribed to my channel and have your post notifications on, you will see me in the future post more videos with me doing the bald cap method, because I do think that method is very important. So I would like to share with you guys how I do it. So I'm just gonna just put this makeup all over. You don't really have to put it all over. This is just a 13x4 wig, so I do wanna make sure that I put it almost to halfway. So now I'm gonna take some free spray and just spray that over my head. This is a cream foundation and I didn't want it to be super messy while applying my wig. So I just put that on and then I'm gonna blow dry it on cool air just so it can kind of freeze up a little bit, because I just don't want the makeup to be everywhere. Excuse the flap in the back of the wig cap. I normally sew that part down, but I just did not want to this time. Like, I just didn't feel like threading needle and doing the most. I didn't. So, yeah. Here, I'm just taking my tweezers and I am just getting all of the hair out the way. I had on lip gloss, so I had hair getting stuck on my lips and everything. So I'm just moving all the hairs out the way, so when I get ready and put my glue and lay it down, there's no hair in the way. Like, this job can get really messy, especially with the glue. So I always make sure that I comb my hair out the way and comb the baby hairs out the way, just so nothing will be in my way and I can really lay the wig down. So I felt like that I could still see a little bit of like a tint look of the bald cap, so I just went in with a smaller brush with the makeup, and now I think it looks so much better. It's blended and it looks good. So now I'm ready to go ahead and lay it. So I am going to be using the Ghost Bond glue. I did get this from Amazon. Majority of the items I'll be using today I did get from Amazon, and I will link everything down below. And I'm also going to be using these popsicle sticks to lay it down. I got so tired of ruining the tails of my combs, so I ordered these popsicle sticks to apply the glue. And I don't remember how much I paid for them. They were affordable, and I think I got like 300 of them. So yeah, just so y'all can stop ruining y'all combs, please order the popsicle sticks. I was moving a little bit fast. I could have let it dry just a little bit more, but I don't know, sometimes when I be blow drying, the glue just seems like it's taking so long and I get impatient. So just have some patience when you're doing this, because you really want to make sure that that glue dries clear before placing your wig, because you will see the glue residue. But I kind of finessed it and fixed my hair real good to where towards the end, you will not see that white residue. When I'm reapplying my wigs, I do find it easy for me to lay down the center part first and then go from side to side. When laying the wig, y'all, really put the comb to use and try your best to keep the hairs out the way. As you can see, I keep combing the hair because once you lay it down, that glue gets really sticky and then it wants to be attached to the hair and then it's just a big mess. So really just be careful, and if you have to keep combing the hairs back just so they won't be on the hairline, then do that. Just too much. Oh my goodness, I really stopped to put lip gloss on. I'm sorry, when my lip gloss ain't glossy and I don't feel like it's popping, I have to re-up. So I had a little excess lace hanging off after I laid it down, so I just took my scissors and just cut that little lace off. Now I'm taking my hot comb and I'm just making sure that all the hair is out of the way and pushed to the back, because I am gonna tie it down just so we can really get the melting effect, and also so we can get rid of like the ashy look. I really just want to make sure that no hair is in my way, so I'm just gonna pull my hair back and clip this away so I can go ahead and tie it down. Now I'm going to take this elastic band. I use this to sew on bands for my wigs, and then I also use it to lay down the lace. I'm just going to wrap it around my head like that just to lay it down and give it like that melting effect. Then I'm also going to take my Sebastian hairspray and spray this along my hairline. Be careful with this. I did kind of spray a little bit too much. You really just want to stay along the hairline. You don't want the hair to get too hard or crunchy or anything. I did kind of use too much, but it's fixable. But you just want to stay along the hairline if you can. now I'm going to work on my baby hair. Since I am going to be crimping my hair, I didn't want to do the most with my baby hairs. Normally, I do the most. So I really just wanted to keep it kind of simple just because I'm going to crimp it. I'm about to do these baby hairs. This side was actually doing pretty well. The other side is what was giving me trouble. I was getting annoyed at some point, but we got it. We got it done. Doing our wigs, our goal is to make this look natural, somewhat like our natural hair. So when I'm doing my baby hairs, I never do like a perfect part. I just take the tail of my comb and I just pull hair out. You can always pull more hair out or add more in, but I always start small because too much hair is gonna make you look not cute. Honestly, I've done it before when I first got into like wearing wigs, but just start small. And just take your time. Take your time. It's really, really, really gonna help. I don't remember where I got this wax stick from, but I'm gonna put everything at the bottom, like I said. Wax sticks are your best friend when doing wigs as well, because plucking, the hair be everywhere, y'all. Like, the hair be everywhere. The wax stick really does help. It lays the hair. It lays the flyaways. So if you don't have one, I would suggest getting one. Or I would also suggest like a good hairspray that will lay it down. Like I said, since I am doing crimps, I really didn't want my baby hairs to kind of take over the style, if that makes sense. So I didn't really want to do too much with the baby hairs. So I'm keeping them pretty simple, like the old way we normally do it. Because now when I do my wigs, I normally curl them with my flat iron and then style it that way. But I'm keeping it simple. So yes, this side was really turning out fine. But the other side, oh my God, y'all about to see me struggling in a minute. Okay, so if y'all can see right here, my baby hairs, they look kind of thick. And I grabbed my tweezers and I just started plucking them some more because thick baby hairs does not look cute. I can't really describe like the look that it gives, but you do not want any like thick baby hair. So once you've already pulled out your baby hairs and everything and you feel like it's too much hair, just take your tweezers and pluck more out, and I promise it will all come together. excuse my lips, I was on the phone and listening to music, jamming out everything. I'm holding it completely wrong on the screen. I wasn't even paying attention, but this is the 3-barrel crimper that I got from Sally's. They do have this on Amazon, but y'all, it's cheaper in Sally's. Like, I went on Amazon and I think I seen like 3 or 4 different ones and they were like $76. I went in Sally's and I believe it was only like $52. So yes, go ahead and get this. It gets really hot. It was my first time using it, but I love it. It got the job done. to make my part look more defined and neat, I'm just going to take my concealer and just put this all on the parts just to make it look more neat. There, I kind of feel like the part got lost with some of the hair. I wanted to pluck it, but I don't know. I just wanted to use the concealer to give it a more defined look. Normally, hairstylists will use like the spray-on black spray. I didn't have any of that, so I'm just using the old mascara wand just to kind of clean up some of the areas where I feel like I put too much concealer on. So now I'm using my Fruit Tea Sleek and Shine Serum. If y'all don't have this for y'all weave, like, y'all really need to get it. Like, it's just a nice serum that makes your hair look nice and shiny. I also use it on my natural hair as well. For this video, I really hope you guys liked it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and you guys will see more of me this time around. I always say this, I'm just not even gonna talk, I'm just do the work. So thanks again for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.